to my channel. Today we are continuing down the Mrs Maisel rabbit hole. I was lucky enough to get my little mittens on the Revlon Mrs Maisel collaboration, where they released some limited edition packed up Revlon products. As we know, Mrs Maisel works for the Revlon counter at B. Aldman's. And throughout the series, they mention the names of some lipsticks that are still available today. Yes, you can go down to your local drugstore, pick them up, and have the perfect Mrs. Maisel pout. And I've got both collaborations. Yes, there are two. We have a reds and a nudes. I'm about to show you all my nudes. The collaborative baby that is a result of the marvelous Mrs. Maisel and Revlon is officially titled the Marvelous Super Lustrous Collection. The stand-up nude set features the colors Rum Raisin, Pink Truffle, and Blushing Mauve, whereas the Take the Stage Reds features Cherries in the Snow, Fire and Ice, and Certainly Red. This collaboration was a celebration of history as well as the actual filming of Mrs. Maisel. For example, the Take the Stage Reds all are officially colours from the 1950s. Cherries in the Snow came out in 1953, Fire and Ice came out in 1952, and Certainly Red came out in 1951. All these lipsticks are mentioned throughout the series, and it's really exciting to be able to actually have them in your hot little hands. Now, when I was researching the Stand Up Nudes collection, I found out that none of these colours are actually from the 50s. In fact, it was really hard to find when these colours were released. So if you have any information on that, please let me know. After a fair amount of internet digging, I was able to find out that Vivian, Midge's friend who also works at the Revlon counter with her, constantly wears Rum Raisin. Midge's mother throughout the series wears, I think it was the Pink Truffle. And whilst Midge is in the Catskills, she wears the final colour, which is Blushing Mauve. Each Mrs. Maisel Revlon lipstick pack comes in these silver envelopes and has a really cute little Mrs. Maisel postcard featuring the lipstick in that exact pack, as well as just a really cute little illustration on the front. Oh no! I just realized we got sent Rum Raisin twice and we are missing Pink Truffle. The two nude lipsticks that we got both apply really smoothly, really easily, and are very moisturizing. I don't feel like my lips are drying out, and that's one of the main perks of a bullet lipstick as opposed to a liquid lipstick. Now, out of these two shades, I think Rum Raisin is my favorite. I do gravitate more towards darker shades, but that's just something that I prefer personally. So let me know which one you think was better. Now that I've shown you my nudes, I will show you the reds. are my thoughts on this collaboration. Each pack retails for about $19 off Amazon, and as far as I know, that's the only place you can purchase it. From my little bit of research, I found out that if I were to purchase each one of these lipsticks, it's $20.99 from my local drugstore. I do love the little postcard that comes in it. It's very cute, very sweet, very simple. However, I'm not overly impressed by the packaging. It is just everyday Revlon lipstick. I personally wish that they had found vintage packaging or had something a little bit more special just for this limited edition release, because really you can just go out and buy them on your own. The only thing that's really special on Mrs. Maisel is the postcard. In saying that, I'm also a little bit let down on the overall silver envelope idea. I understand it's really simple, other cosmetic companies use it, but I'm just never impressed by it. I was really hoping for maybe a beautiful box or a beautiful little bag, just something that makes it a little bit more vintage and a little bit more special. In saying that, I have actually never tried a Revlon lipstick and I am really impressed. These are super pigmented. I don't know if you noticed, by the time I was swatching the last one on my wrist, my skin was stained and my lips were stained. I had to go and put another quick layer of foundation over my lips just to try and get as much color that was true, as opposed to pulling out the red tone underneath the previous color. Does that make sense? No, that's fine. I am really impressed by that. They are also super moisturizing. They feel really nice on the lips. They're nice and slippery and silky, which is lovely. I do not believe these to be kiss-proof, touch-proof, eating-proof. They are going to smear, so if that's something that bothers you, probably not the best bet. Out of both sets, I think the winner in the nudes for me is definitely Rum Raisin. And as for the reds, I believe I am Team Fire and Ice. I also just love the original campaign and what it stood for. If you want to read up on that, it's in my blog. It is really interesting. And that is all I have to say on the Mrs. Maisel and Revlon collaboration. It was a lot of fun to review these lipsticks. I am still learning how to review beauty products. Unfortunately, I've had a massive endo flare-up over the past 2 months, which means my skin is in absolute turmoil. So I'm sorry if I am not that pleasant to look at up close. Trust me, I don't even want to look at myself up close. But I couldn't resist trying out these lipsticks, and I really hope you enjoy the journey regardless. As always, you can find detailed photos and descriptions of everything in my blog, which is in the description box below, as well as links to purchase your own Mrs. Maisel lipstick packs. A massive thank you to everyone who has subscribed, liked, and commented on my posts so far. It is so wonderful seeing everyone enjoying it, as well as sharing tips and tricks. Everything is appreciated. Thank you so much. I can't thank you all enough. I just can't wait to see where this goes. Until next week, I will see you all on the socials. If you'd like to follow me there, feel free. Everything is linked below. I hope you all have a wonderful weekend and stay happy and healthy. I'm sending you all love. Bye!